time to get out. Step out into the street where all of the action is right there.
I've got a list. You're just going to have to deal with it.
Welcome back to the Project Gen X podcast. I am one of your hosts, Alan Smith, along with...
I'm the other guy, Big Dave. Deal with it.
And I'm Barry. I'm dealing with it.
Okay. So in this episode, I threw out a... Hey, let's make lists. We'll do our picks of the best songs from 80s soundtracks. Now, I came at it with a couple rules, and then Barry threw one on top of it that complicated things even more. But this is what I started with. First off, the song has to actually appear on the soundtrack.
Yes.
Okay.
Screw you.
Which did not just in the not just you know a song that was
you,
in
you did this just to stick a finger.
Well,
in
no, oh, this is better. because of there are plenty of times where songs appear in the song, but they're in the movie, but they're not actually on the soundtrack,
which is a mistake. Yes. Because sometimes they're the best songs on.
I guarantee you, one of the first ones that you went to that wound up not being on a soundtrack was "Cruel Summer."
He's right. It's not on
Cruel Summer by Bananarama.
It's
not on the soundtrack for The Karate Kid. It's in the movie. It is featured prominently, it is not on the soundtrack.
Yeah. Screw you guys. So, it's one of the best songs in the movie.
Basically, what we're going to do is Dave's going to say something, and we're going to fact check it.
Oh,
no. He's going to have all this stuff.
Oh, no, because I already went and checked it against friggin' IMDb's sound.
Oh, no. That doesn't count.
No, you can't use that.
You can't use that either because I found stuff on there that's not. And here's the reason why.
No.
One of the songs that I wanted to put on this was, after all, Sharon Peter Cetera, which is from the movie Chances. Chances are doesn't have a soundtrack.
Yep.
It never released a soundtrack. That movie was that song was nominated, and I think actually won the Oscar that year for some, but they never put out an official soundtrack. Ferris Bueller's Day Off does not have a soundtrack.
Nope.
It was never released. So anything that's featured in that movie does not count. And Dave's going to be doing the fact check now. So yeah, a lot of Spotify playlists have songs that are featured in movies, but they're for soundtracks, but aren't actually on the soundtracks.
What do you mean Ferris Bueller's Day didn't?
There is not a soundtrack that was ever released. The closest that happened was that there were, what was it, 3,000 singles that were, there was a double-sided single of songs that were on, that were in the movie that were released through a fan club. That's it.
Well, I hate this episode already. It's bullcrap.
John Hughes even went on record as saying there was no official soundtrack and he regrets not releasing it.
Because I was this close to putting Donkashane on.
I know. Just, so anything.
See, I did March of the Swivelheads.
Oh, good choice.
Now I can't because Alan is a jerk.
But no. But then Barry had to go and say, hey, I've got another rule. Oh, the other rule that I had before you started was that it had to appear on a soundtrack that was released in the 80s.
Yep.
So none of this Wedding Singer BS or Take Me Home Tonight BS or any of that kind of stuff of like movies that are set in the 80s but were made in the 2000s or the 90s or the 2000s.
Right.
So yeah, that was my other rule. Then Barry came in and complicated things even more.
Of course.
Go ahead, tell him what it is.
My rule was that you cannot use a song that shares the title of the movie.
Like,
couldn't use Purple Rain.
Right.
You know, you couldn't.
And you know, the two songs that I had that I was like, oh, these are going to be great ones. Mm-hmm. Then later I was like, motherfucker, I had to take these off.
It's all right. I killed myself too. Cause one of my favorites I had to pull.
Light of Day. I couldn't use that one. And Rock and Roll High School. Yep. I could not use that one either.
I couldn't use 9 to 5.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah,
I actually have several that I did not use. Never Ending Story. We couldn't use.
I know, that was another one. I know.
View to a Kill.
I know. I had that one. That was the very first one I had on there. I was like, mother...
Pretty in Pink, you couldn't use.
Yeah.
I hate both of you. I hate both of you right now.
And I was even harder on myself because even if it was a, you know, if it
Footloose
the
couldn't
title,
be used, you know, that was a. Oh, I know stuff that like that it's in the parentheses. Yep. I know. I was like, we can't use those either.
Flash's theme from Flash Gordon, I couldn't use.
I know.
And that just broke my heart because it's Queen. You know,
I know.
It's one of my favorites. And the other one that I love.
I can already tell I'm going to get angry and walk out on this.
Lost
episode.
In the Shadows, Lost Boys.
Yep. Couldn't use it.
Couldn't use it.
But, you know, the one that broke my heart was a movie that, if you guys have seen this, I'll be amazed. The lead singer from the Human League had a song called Together in Electric Dreams.
Electric Dreams, yeah. That's,
I love that freaking movie, and I love that song, and I couldn't use it, and it broke my heart.
That's the one with Andy Kaufman, is that? Or is that thinking of something else? No, Electric Dreams is...
You're thinking Heartbeats.
Heartbeats is what I was thinking of, yeah.
Electric Dreams had Virginia Madsen.
Yes, that's what it was.
All right, let's get this nightmare over with.
All right.
Who wants to start?
Alan, why don't you kick it off?
No, he always kicks it off.
All right,
he
thinks
he's the owner.
Dave,
no, I'm going to let Barry go first.
No.
I want Barry to go first.
All right, I'll go first. Since we couldn't use too much of this, I'm going to go with a scene from a movie that is probably the most paused scene in movie history.
I didn't
and
know
the
Fatal
song
Attraction
that was playing
came out
in the background.
In
the, movie was Fast Times at Ridgemont High. The song is Moving in Stereo by the Cars.
I've got that one on my list.
Yeah, I do not have that one on my list.
That is the scene where Phoebe is coming out of the pool.
And if you guys hadn't figured it out, there's going to be a lot of all of us or multiple,
we're
at least
crossing
two or three
out
of
as we
us
go.
Have the same songs on the, so.
Hold on, I got to figure that, where is that? Where did I go? Mark that off my list.
All right.
I only put 15 on mine.
Oh, I've got
I could have gone way, way more on it. But we said 15. We compromised on 15 also.
So we're going to have honorable mentions too. So.
I'm sure.
All right, I'm going to go easy on the very first one, 1980, Caddyshack. Kenny Loggins.
I'm all right.
I'm all right.
All right. There you go. I don't have that one either. So
you can't have an 80s soundtrack movie episode without having a Kenny Loggins.
I do have a Kenny Loggins song on here.
I think I almost threw out the Loggins Collins rule. No Kenny Loggins, no Phil Collins.
Yeah.
But I did not.
That would take a couple of mine off
exactly
of here.
Exactly.
Oh, that was another one. One of my other ones, Against All Odds.
Yeah.
Phil Collins. I was like, fuck, that's the name of the movie it was on.
Nope.
But I am going to go with Highway to the Danger Zone, Kenny Loggins, Top Gun soundtrack, 1986.
Right. I stayed away from that because I knew somebody was going to
You see, there's so many of these soundtracks that have just multiple different songs that you could go with.
Yeah. Then that with Playing with the Boys. I almost put Take My Breath Away on here by Berlin, but I decided not to.
What was the Cheap Trick song that was off of that? That was really good. Mighty Wings.
Yeah, something
that's
like
another
that,
great
so.
One, you know?
Yeah.
All right, Barry, we're back around.
I'm
going to
throw one out that the infamous Amy actually threw at me, and I didn't even think about it. From the movie An American Tale.
Somewhere out there. Linda Ronstadt.
Yes.
And,
Peebo Bryson. Yes. That is an amazing song.
Yeah. It's all right.
Shut up. It's good. Go ahead, Dave.
My wife was very, because when I told her what we were talking about, she started throwing in going, oh, what about this one? And her friend Tanya was like, oh, what about this one?
This morning, this was the entire conversation.
And she's very mad at me because I have zero Disney on here. I was like the other two guys.
I have zero Disney.
I have zero Disney also. But
that,
really and truly, when you go back.
That is a Don Bluth. That is not a Disney.
Right.
You're right. Okay. But she wanted me to very much put, you know, something from
Little Mermaid.
Yeah,
89.
Or,
yeah, I know.
Because that started
Beauty and the Beast.
That era.
That's 90s.
Is that 90s?
Yes.
Start?
Well, because Little Mermaid started that next wave of Disney stuff.
Right.
So she's kind of frustrated with me right now. Sorry, babe.
Okay.
1980.
Yes.
Urban Cowboy.
Ooh,
which one?
Looking for Love in All the Right Places.
Went Down to Georgia.
Oh, okay. I would have
That is on
the soundtrack.
It is on the soundtrack. It is on the soundtrack.
I would have thought, could I have
And that the means. the live performance of that in the movie is just excellent.
All right. I'm going to do this one. I'm going to be massively surprised if it's not on Dave's.
What?
Who Made Who by AC/DC.
It's on mine.
It's on the Maximum Overdrive soundtrack.
Maximum
1986.
Overdrive. Yeah.
But basically any AC/DC song that was on there.
Yeah. That was the new song that they did.
That whole Who Made Who album.
Yes.
It's just amazing.
It shook me all night long. Hell's Bells is on there. Yeah, no, it's
all right. I'm going to throw one over here that's going to put a smile on my man Dave's face because I know it's one of his favorite bands. And it's actually in a movie that we talked about. From the soundtrack, and yes, there is a soundtrack for Major League.
Yes, there is.
Wild Thing by X.
Yes, there you go.
I love that their cover.
The old John Moxley.
Yes. Well, okay, and I found something out about this. And this for all of our listeners who are looking for a little Easter egg to give yourself a little fun. There is an artist by
that just sounds dirty.
Yeah, well, there's an artist by the name of Ronnie Millsap.
Yes.
And, you know, famously blind piano player.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Amazing songwriter, amazing performer.
He's having daydreams about night things.
Yes.
In the middle of the afternoon.
Had a song in
a Smoky
80s.
Mountain rain.
That's right.
Had a song in the 80s that is quite possibly the
He's
most
got the Friday 80s, Night Blues, too.
So. The most 80s video I've ever seen Which in my one? Entire life. Actually, Friday Night Blues with John Conley.
Oh, that's right. You're
oh,
right.
I shut him
yeah,
down.
You got
yeah. I shut him down.
That's right. Nice. That is John Conley. That's true.
She Loves My Car.
Yes, I remember that video.
Now, do you remember?
I'm glad that
you know who was
R.
in that video. So, first off, the main female in that video was Mariska Hargitay.
Yes, that's right.
But there's a scene in it where these two people pull up beside them in the car wearing leather jackets, and the guy's playing guitar. It's the two people from X, the lead singer and the lead guitarist from X.
So you're talking about John Doe,
John, yeah,
the
John
drummer,
Doe
and Billy Bones.
Yes.
I did not realize.
Go back that. And watch it. And it, trust right. me, it is the most 80s thing you'll ever see. Go ahead, Dave.
Well, since you did one for me, I'm going to do one for you.
Bring it.
This is Spinal Tap.
Oh, Big Bottom.
Big Bottom.
Big Bottom.
Because they're all playing bass. 1984.
The bigger the cushion, the sweeter the pushing.
Talk about bun cakes, my baby's.
Yes.
I know.
You could have done Stonehenge, but it's still great.
I almost went with Stonehenge, but I was like, no, I'll do this one for Barry.
Yes.
I am actually double dipping on this one.
All right.
Because it appeared on two soundtracks.
Okay.
1983's Risky Business and 1985's Miami Vice soundtrack.
Which one?
Phil Collins, In the Air Tonight.
Oh.
It is on both of those soundtracks.
Right. Okay.
It is on both of those soundtracks.
It's a good song.
It is.
Still breaks my heart that that's not him playing drums.
I know.
All right. So this is one of my guilty pleasures when I was a kid. I loved this freaking movie, and I don't care what anybody says because it had a great, great,
oh, wait.
Great sound.
We may have the same one because I had picked another one.
From the 1986 epic classic Rad.
Oh, you did that.
Send Me an Angel.
Yes.
By Real Life.
Yes.
I know the song, but I was like, oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, I've got that on my list also.
Oh, such a cheeseball movie with Lori Loughlin, but I don't care. It's so much fun.
Well, there was an Australian answer to it.
Oh, was there?
That had...
Yeah, Nicole Kidman.
Nicole Kidman in it. It's called BMX.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I haven't seen
this.
That was
like her first movie.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. I'll check
and she has a very thick Australian accent.
Very thick.
It was an HBO movie.
one of my... The infamous Amy loves to, you know, whenever we start talking about Nicole Kidman, she, let me out of the car, Cole. Let me out of the car.
Well, it's really funny to like her and Mel Gibson both. Like,
oh, yeah.
When they first got started, had really thick.
They lost it and then they got it back.
Gone.
Yeah.
So.
All right, Dave.
Since you went with Rad.
Yes.
I will go with 1986 Thrashing.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, yes.
Wild in the Streets, Circle Jerks.
Nice choice. Nice pull.
I figured, you know, BMX and skating were right there together, and they were making movies about both.
Oh, yeah.
All right, fine. Since you guys both went weird, I'm going to go weird.
Please go weird. I love weird. Go ahead.
1986. The name of the song is Skid Row Downtown.
Okay.
Rick Moranis and Ellen Green from the Little Shop of Horrors soundtrack.
See, now, I love it. It's one of my favorites, one of my absolute favorites. I would have thought you would have done Somewhere That's Green.
No, I love that song.
I was about to say, that's
I
an
love that
song.
Whole that. Poor all my life, I've always been poor. I keep asking God what I'm for. And he tells me, gee, I'm not sure. Sweep that floor, kid. Oh.
All right.
I love that movie and that soundtrack.
Okay.
I mean, just I dabble with maybe Dentist.
See, I love that.
That was, but I was like,
I'm a dentist.
I know. But then I was like, no, I'm going with Skid Row because that's my favorite one.
Yeah, okay. Well,
and a movie that you had just brought up, sir, I'm going to bring it up, from the Karate Kid soundtrack, which there was one.
There was.
From Joe Esposito.
Oh, you I had it on mine.
You're the best.
Around.
Nothing's ever going to break you down.
That is a great song.
It is.
It is a great
song. That is a banger.
Great
it is an absolute
song.
Banger. You know?
That is one of those songs.
Well, it was supposed to have been for Rocky.
Yeah, it was. He wrote it for Rocky.
That is one of those songs that for people of our age especially.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I know it's kind of, it came back with Cobra Kai and the younger generation, but for people our age, that is one of those songs that you can put on and everybody's like, oh, yeah. Yep. And that was... was it ever even released as a single? I don't think it was, you know, and it's like, if it was, it didn't do well, you know, but it's one of those, like, it's become iconic.
Yes.
So. All right.
What you got, Dave?
1984. Uh-huh. Okay. Repo Man.
Which song?
Yeah, I looked at that soundtrack. And I was like, I would just have to go with every song.
Yeah, here. Exactly.
I mean, this is
because I've
it Black
seen
Flag.
No, going, I have okay. seen this band in concert.
X
Institutionalize
suicidal tendencies. Yes, I've seen them in concert also. So,
can I just say that movie?
Were you at the? Were you at the show?
I wasn't
with
at
Queentrack?
No.
Oh, that is show. That is an
everybody take a drink
gem.
You know? Man, screw you. Screw you. I'm sorry I haven't seen as many concerts as you have. I've got to reminisce about the ones I have seen.
I know. They're great live.
Jerk. Yeah.
All right, senor.
Where am I want to go in here? All right. Just because I can't believe it, no one has said it yet.
Okay.
I figured this would be one of the first ones off the board.
All right.
1982, Rocky III soundtrack. Eye of the Tiger, Survivor.
See, I went with a Rocky.
I tried to stay away from the stuff that I thought you two would pick up.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. But I was like, best songs from 80 soundtracks. It doesn't get any better than that.
I beg to differ, sir.
Okay.
I beg to differ.
Okay.
That one got a lot of airplay, mm-hmm. but there is a better song from a Rocky movie, and I have it.
What is
from Rocky IV?
Ah, fuck Rocky.
Robert IV, Tepper, No Easy Way Out.
And
that's a good song.
That I'm sorry.
It's no Eye
of the Tiger, though. I have to agree with Alan on that.
Sorry. That Eye of the Tiger is one of those you hear that dun, 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 everybody's in. I mean, that no ifs, ands,
just because
buts.
They all said right. the line in the movie.
All right.
Go ahead, Dave.
Dave.
1985. Legend of Billy Jean.
Oh,
is that
85?
That
is 85.
85.
Is it Invincible?
Invincible.
Well, yes. Benatar. That's a good
yes.
Do we need to check and make sure there actually was a
no,
soundtrack?
There was
go a ahead. Soundtrack. Go ahead. Double check me. I don't give a crap.
All right, fine. I'm going to go ahead and take mine.
All right.
1986. You remind me of the Babe.
See, I
knew you were going that way.
Magic Dance by David Bowie.
I knew you were going to pull that one, Labyrinth. Which is why I didn't even bother.
Okay. I'm going to throw one out here that is one of my all-time favorite songs, has been one of my favorite songs for many, many years, and was the first song that really introduced me to this artist in the way that I know her now.
Mm-hmm.
From the 1985 movie Vision Quest.
Oh, good movie.
Madonna.
Crazy for You
that's
by
a good
Madonna.
One.
I love that song.
It's a good movie.
That is a good one. That is a good one.
Hmm. What you got,
Dave? Since you took one of mine, I'm getting ready to add something else to this one.
All right.
1987.
Yes.
Some Kind of Wonderful.
Oh, one of my favorite movies. What song did you choose?
The Hardest Walk, the Jesus and Mary Chain.
See, I had on Lick the Tins doing their cover of Can't Help Falling in Love with You.
Yeah.
I hate that version.
I love that version so much.
I hate her voice. I
but
cannot
it fits.
Stand her voice.
It so fits, you know?
I love... Back in the day, I listened to a lot of Jesus and Mary Chain. I just loved that over-reverbed wall of noise kind of thing that they were doing.
Well, you could have gone with that. You could have gone with the Lick the Tins. You could have gone with whoever did the version of Miss Amanda Jones, which was really good off of that one.
Yep.
There was another one that surprised me. Oh, crap.
But if you haven't seen the movie, Some Kind of Wonderful.
Charlie Sexton's Beat So Crazy. Yeah.
See, I think it's lesser.
You didn't like that one?
I didn't like that one as much.
I like that one.
It's because the girl's a drummer. That's why you like it.
Oh, stop. What do you got, Alan?
Okay, I'm not going to lie. I love.
See, I know Dave. Yeah.
I love girl drummers. Yeah. I can't help it.
Hey.
It's the drummer in me.
All right.
You're a Sheila fan, aren't you?
No, he does not like her. Okay.
Whatever.
All right. I was torn on what song to take off of this soundtrack.
I'm probably
that,
got
that
one.
Song is not on a soundtrack.
This one,
I'm not even going to get a response out of that.
No,
go ahead.
The 1984,
mm-hmm.
the cult classic, Streets of Fire.
Oh, I've got like three songs here. So what do you got?
I really originally wanted to do Tonight Is What It's Like. Tonight's
By
What It's
Fire
Like
Incorporated.
But I had to go with Dan Hartman, I Can Dream About You, because
I
love that song.
And I also have One Bad Stud.
Yeah, One Bad Stud. That's a good one also.
I love that freaking song.
But I did. I was like, I really want to put Tonight Is What It's Like to Be Young. But
or
I like,
Sorcerer.
That's, I just wanted a Jim Steinman song is what I wanted.
Well, it's Jim Steinman and Ry Cooder. Yeah. I mean, come on. How do you go wrong with that, you know?
But there is no denying that I Can Dream About You is a great, not just a soundtrack song, but it is a great 80s song.
Very
we're
much
talking
so.
About
Very
that.
Much so.
So go ahead.
I'm sorry. I thought you were taking that one of mine.
No.
All right.
No.
All right. I will throw one out here. from the Rock and Roll High School soundtrack, because I'm sure you're going to have one too.
I don't.
I want you around.
Okay. I
just for that scene. That is like the perfect song for that scene.
I originally had Rock and Roll High School on here.
Right.
And then I thought about maybe putting that medley, since, you know, it's like all this.
Right.
But I was like, you know what? Rock and Roll, the song Rock and Roll High School is probably the most solid song on here. I mean, there's good stuff on there, don't get me wrong. And I've got a copy of that on
Well, you got I there. Want You Around. You've
I
know. Got, I just want to have something
Except
to do.
For What's Her Name's version of Rock and Roll High School.
Yeah, that was
which
horrible.
Is terrible.
That was absolutely PJ Harvey.
Yeah, not
or PJ Souls.
PJ Souls.
Yeah, there
Harvey.
You go.
Harvey's a completely different person. Yeah. She can sing.
Well, debatable, but go ahead. All right, Dave.
Better than Souls.
Fair. Yeah, but she's setting the bar real low. Yeah.
1984.
Yep.
Okay.
16 Candles.
Which song?
Turning Japanese, The Vapors.
See, I went with the Thompson Twins, If You Were Here.
Well, I figured
just for this, that song is so synonymous with that scene.
I know, but that's the one that everybody knows from that movie, and they forget that this is also on that soundtrack.
Well, that's true.
Well, since we're in John Hughes land right here, I went with 1985's A Breakfast Club, Don't You Forget About Me.
Oh, yeah,
The Single Minds.
I knew one of you two would pick that up, so I didn't even bother.
All right.
I really wish I had my albums unpacked right now, because I'd be just pulling them out like, okay, off of this album I went with and out of this one I went with.
Yeah, that's just you showing off of your vinyl.
Yeah, pretty much, because I've got a really nice vinyl collection now.
Yeah, why don't you keep rubbing it in?
So I'm going to throw an unusual choice out.
Okay.
And this is one that the song, the version of this song is hauntingly good.
Okay.
This is...
She's Like the Wind.
No. From 1988.
Okay.
The movie She's Having a Baby.
Okay.
Has this woman's work done by Kate Bush.
Okay.
It is hauntingly good. I mean, Kate Bush, I love this woman no matter what, but just hearing that version of that song in that scene, it fits so perfectly. And yes, there is a soundtrack for it. I looked.
Okay.
What you got, Dave?
You didn't say what the song was.
Yes, I did. This Woman's Work.
Oh, is that what?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were saying This Woman's Work was like, Woman's Work was.
We were all
like,
sitting here waiting and waiting
what,
for the
what
title
kind of work
of
is this woman doing that's so good? You know, it's.
No, the song is called This Woman's Work.
Okay.
Wow, that all that build up for
and
the
we're both
letdown.
Like, huh?
We're like, what? Huh? What?
Yeah, you know,
what's the name of the song?
Uncultured, you know.
Leave it to a bass player to build
heathens.
Up to the lead to nothing.
Shut
so.
Up. Dave, exactly. Do something.
Exactly. I got a double shot from 1987.
All right.
Okay.
From the Less Than Zero soundtrack.
Okay.
Hazy Shade of Winter.
No.
I had that one on mine.
Mm-mm. I had that one too.
Bring the Noise from Public Enemy and Going Back to Cali from LL Cool
J. I almost put All Going right. Back to Cali, you know?
I don't think you get to put two songs on there, though.
Too bad I did it anyway. I just did it.
I can edit that. So.
I just did it.
What have I not said so yet? Oh,
this is why I'm making little check marks.
Another one from another soundtrack that could have pulled a bunch of different songs off of.
Yep.
And there was one other one specifically I wanted, but then I decided on this one instead.
Okay.
1984, again, because 84 seems to be like, I have like five songs off of soundtracks from 84. Footloose soundtrack.
Okay.
Holding Out for a Hero, Bonnie Tyler.
Such a good song.
I know.
Yes.
I know.
And I actually went with a different one.
Okay. I'll
throw mine out there. I went with Never by Moving Pictures.
Okay.
Because that's just that whole scene where he's like raging in the
warehouse.
The warehouse.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
And they, I always find it funny that everybody thinks that they're playing the song Footloose in that scene.
No.
And it's not.
Nope. Footloose doesn't come into the very end of the movie.
Yep.
At the dance.
Yep.
All right, Dave, what you got?
From 1989.
Yes.
And mainly because this band just released a new single for the first time in 15 years.
What extreme song is it?
Play With Me.
From?
The Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure soundtrack.
Gosh. And the bad part is I wanted Bogus Journey to be on there so badly. So
but it's 91.
I know. I wanted it to be in there so badly just so I could do God Gave Rock and Roll to You too.
Yes.
You know?
But no.
That's not a good song.
but the fact that it's Kiss covering Petra just makes me...
Still,
it's,
I mean,
still
that's
funny.
Yeah. But yes, Extreme.
Good choice.
And that new Extreme song, I don't hate it.
I've listened to it a couple of times after you posted it. It's not bad. It's not them at their best.
I kind of like it because
it's
I think Gary Sharon's voice has gotten better It's got a little bit more gravel to it now.
Well, you know, you spend that time with Van Halen, you know, things are going to happen.
Who's going to mention Van Halen? This is seriously. Have they announced who's taking Eddie Van Halen's place in the band?
That band is over. Yeah,
let it die.
It's what they do. Somebody leaves the band, they just replace them with somebody else.
There's a difference between firing.
There's already two Van Halens in the band. Yes, they're fine.
But there's a difference between being fired and dying.
Technically, okay? There's only one Van Halen in the band.
There's two.
Who's the other one?
Wolfgang.
Wolfgang is not in the band.
He's not part of the band.
He's not in the band anymore?
He's, nope. No, he's got his own project.
Right. He was the bass player for it for a short time. I remember that.
Very short time.
What are you talking about? After they got rid of Michael Anthony, he came in and took over.
I thought he was the filler, and then they
brought him on tour with them for the last 10 years that they were.
No, he's got his own project called Mammoth.
Okay.
And he's putting out some really decent stuff.
But I just thought the rule was as long as there's two Van Halens in the band, then
There's only one Van Halen in the band.
And the Taylor Hawkins tribute.
But that's the only reason he even did.
But just to see him get up there and start playing his dad's guitar, his dad's rig, and his dad's notes was just freaking phenomenal.
And did a really excellent job of it.
He shredded. Yeah. What do you got?
We're done now. Okay.
He doesn't like Van Halen.
I'm really.
He
can, I can smell the bitterness. Go ahead.
He can bite me.
That band got so much better when Sammy Hagar joined.
No, I'm not going to disagree.
No, I agree with you.
I like some of the.
I know that really will irritate people when I say it, but it's true.
You're a Van Hagar fan.
I like the Van Hagar stuff.
I will say it like this, okay? And this is my defense on this. With David Lee Roth, it was a lot more fun.
It was a party band.
It was a lot more fun.
They were still a party band with Hagar.
It got more serious
it
with
did.
Hagar.
With Hagar, it got more musically
mature.
Mature.
They became a band.
Yes.
When he got in the when he joined. Prior, when David Lee Roth was in the group, it was David Lee Roth and Van Halen.
True.
Okay? Well, when Van Halen first got signed, Ted Templeton was actually trying to get rid of David Lee Roth and put Sammy Hagar there in the first place.
Yep.
He fought for months to put Sammy Hagar as the lead singer of that band when they first got signed.
Do you know who Eddie wanted to replace David Lee Roth with but could not get her? Patti Smyth.
I can see that.
Eddie came to her before they ever talked to Sammy.
Yeah.
And wanted her in the band. And I think she was pregnant at the time.
She probably loved it.
Couldn't go. I would love to have seen her.
Oh, yeah.
That would have been awesome.
But you know, Alan, sometimes love just ain't enough.
I know.
But go ahead.
That's true.
Go ahead.
But see, they wouldn't. Yeah. Seriously. You have Don Henley to come in and sing on that to make it really good. So it's.
Go on. What's your choice?
She's just saying goodbye to you at that point.
So. What's your next song? What's your next song?
And
you're trying too hard at this point. What's your next song?
Well, hey, we all know that Matthew McConaughey was Walk Away Joe. So come on. That was.
Would you go on to your next one on your list, please, huh?
And he complains about us.
I know.
Podcast.
Yeah. Okay. Another big soundtrack. Could have pulled a bunch of stuff in 1984. Beverly Hills Cop. I went with the Pointer Sisters and Neutron Day.
That's a good one. That's actually on my list.
Yeah, that's a great song. A few years later that Disney came along and ripped them off for DuckTales.
But well, that's true.
I'm telling you, those songs are exactly the theme song for DuckTales and Neutron Dance. You can play them over top of each other, and they're exact same song.
Yeah.
So they even got the woohoos in there. Yep. So
all right, I'm gonna get in touch with my inner prog rock. So Dave instantly perked up. From the 1980 movie Xanadu.
Oh, God.
I'm Alive by ELO.
Are they prog rock?
They qualify.
Yeah, they do on the lighter side.
I refuse to do the song Xanadu just because it doesn't meet the rules.
I thought they were just a Beatles cover band. So.
Dave, what song do you have chosen next? We're just going to pretend he's not here right now. Go ahead.
1987.
Yes.
The movie Can't Buy Me Love.
Ooh, good song. Or good track. Good movie. That too.
Dancing with Myself. Billy Idol.
Is that on the soundtrack?
Double check me.
I don't know on that one.
Can't Buy Me
I remember it in the movie, but I don't remember seeing it on the soundtrack, so I don't know.
Hold on. We're doing the fact check live.
Because I hit two or three different sites looking for soundtracks, and it was on there.
Can't Buy Me Love. soundtrack. this could become contemptuous here. So,
should we start humming the theme to Jeopardy?
Can't buy me love.
Which, funny enough, that song wasn't featured in the movie until the very, very end.
Yeah,
it makes sense. You know, I mean, why not? I mean, that's a, you know what? I'm not even seeing a soundtrack here.
There's a soundtrack for it. The movie didn't do very well.
I remember the soundtrack.
Didn't the woman that was in that pass away a few years ago?
Yeah, she had a really rough, like, her story is absolutely tragic.
Yeah.
I'm not seeing a soundtrack at all.
I found it on, like, three different websites.
Okay.
Hold on. Let me check one more place. Because that was a thing that got me with a couple of things where I had to go to multiple places of like, okay, so where is there a soundtrack?
You know the easiest way to find this out, right?
Wikipedia.
No, Amazon.
Yeah, if there's not one available, then all right, let's see. Soundtrack.
I'm trying to think of any of the other music that was from that
soundtrack. In 2013, Intricha Records released Robert Fulk's complete score for the film on a limited edition CD. There is no soundtrack for that movie.
Oh, horse crap. Absolute horse crap.
All right. That's probably not going to be the last time we run into this. So
that's why. And again, I went through, yeah, there were several things like, there is no soundtrack for this, you know, for several things that I wanted, but. All right.
Found it on like three different websites.
It doesn't matter. Believe me, like I
said,
I saw stuff, several things, several places, especially like with IMDb. And so where they list all this stuff. And I'm like, I know that's not on the soundtrack. I know that's not on the soundtrack. It's in the movie, but it's not on the soundtrack. So
screw you then.
All right. Since we debunked that one.
Since you debunked that one, I'm going to go again. I'm going to do one just to annoy the crap out of you. Mm. 1985.
Okay.
Real Genius.
Okay.
Summertime Girls by Y&T.
Ooh.
Okay.
I had Everybody Wants to Rule the World, but that works too.
I had them both on there. I kept that one as a way to try to annoy Al.
I actually like that song. Go ahead.
It's an all right song. I'm just going to do it. 1984.
Mm-hmm.
Purple Rain.
Mm-hmm.
Let's Go Crazy.
Okay.
That Prince. I mean, that was my introduction to Prince.
That's everybody's introduction to Prince.
But that song specifically, where I was like, I remember hearing that at 10 years old, was not playing a musical instrument at the time,
mm-hmm.
and really, you know, had, outside of just what I had heard in my very limited time at that point,
right.
I remember hearing that guitar solo
that he
goes into and being like, this guy's good. And
we are gathered here to get through this called life.
But it's also one of those things of like, I still say this all these years later. Mm-hmm. Prince was one of the most underrated guitarists
ever. You don't even say guitarist, musician in
general. But especially for his guitar playing.
Oh.
A lot of people just really overlooked it. It's like, no.
All they have to do is watch the video
of
the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
It was like him and George Harrison.
While My Guitar Gently Weeps.
God,
I know.
He
comes on and destroys it and just walks off stage like a pimp. I mean, it's just
nothing
like
ever happened.
Danny Harrison's just standing in the back playing acoustic guitar and be like,
with this huge grin on his face.
I cannot believe I'm part of this.
Well, it's also Tom Petty. He's just like looking at him while he's singing it the whole time. I'm like, what is he doing?
Yeah. and plus, what happened to the guitar he threw up in the air?
It never came
it's
down.
Still there.
It never. Apparently,
still
it's still floating over Cleveland.
It orbits
somewhere. Yeah,
it's orbiting right now.
Yeah.
NASA's picked it up. All right, I've got one, and mine is from one of my favorite cheeseball movies of all time.
Okay.
All right. 1983, Scarface.
Okay.
Push It to the Limit by Paul Esterhaus.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Never liked that movie.
That song has been used in so many different things.
I don't even know the song.
Oh, trust me. You know it. You know it. When
is that
it,
the one that like in the middle of the movie when they had that extended music video?
Yep.
Okay. It's that song. It's annoying as shit.
Well, yes, but do you get more quintessential 80s than that?
Early 80s, maybe.
I rest my case. It was 83. What do you want?
Early 80s. You know, it's
all right, go ahead, Dave.
1989.
Okay.
Okay.
Say Anything.
Oh, you could go a lot of ways.
Which one?
In Your Eyes.
Yeah.
Peter Gabriel.
I love that song.
I love it.
Overrated.
But there's a lot of good songs on that soundtrack.
You want to fight? You want to go out in your brand new yard and fight? Because I'll fight you.
All right. What do you got, Alan?
What do I have left? Oh, 1987, Lost Boys soundtrack.
Which one?
Good Times, NXS and Jimmy Barnes.
See, I thought that.
Yeah.
I thought...
Dave would have the Echo and the Bunny Men, People Are Strange on it, so I stayed away from that.
That's what I had.
I really wanted to put Lost in the Shadows, but it's Lost Boys. It's like, that's the name of the song, or name of the movie, so it's...
I hate the fact that he thinks I'm so predictable.
Well, yeah.
Or that I just tell the same stories over and over and over. Well, screw both of you.
All right, so I'm going to throw one out here. Again, bit of an unusual choice, but... I absolutely love this artist. I absolutely love this song. And this is like the ultimate women's rally cry.
Mm-hmm.
From the 1988 movie Working Girl, Let the River Run.
Is that Carly Simon?
That is Carly Simon.
I fucking hate Carly Simon.
I know you do, and that's why I said it. Mm. But aside from the fact that it is an absolutely amazing song, and I have never met somebody that...
Didn't she do the theme song to Ally McBeal?
No, that was Vonda Shepherd.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Asshole.
You tell me the difference between the two of them.
About 25 years. All right, Dave, what do you got?
Let's see here.
Surprisingly, I still have a couple of them on here that hadn't been said.
Same here. Mm-hmm.
And I only have like 15 songs.
1989.
Okay.
I like that you went kind of later 80s on a lot of these.
I went back and forth. I tried to go through the whole decade. Do the Right Thing.
Fight the Power.
Fight the Power.
That is
Public
Enemy.
Is
that on the soundtrack?
Go ahead, jerk. Go ahead. Double check me. Go ahead. Let's just go ahead.
It very well could be. I mean, I could be completely wrong about that one.
He's just doing this to me.
He's doing it out of spite. We know. It's all right.
Do the Right Thing.
Yeah, double check his work, Barry.
Actually, I'm looking up mine really quick.
To make sure everybody's...
I'm just double checking.
This may be my last podcast episode.
No, it won't. I think it's music from Do the Right Thing. Is that a soundtrack? If it's music from...
You know, it has to be original motion picture soundtrack.
That was not in the rules.
Yeah, that's on music from, because the official soundtrack is all score.
Yeah, I'm out of here. This is my last episode. I am not doing this with you two anymore.
Well, that's all right. Because of his rules, it kind of changed mine a little bit, too. So.
No, I'm out of here. I'm done. I'm done.
What do you got, Alan?
1986, Pretty in Pink.
What song?
If You Leave. Orchestra Maneuvers in the Dark.
I went left of center with Suzanne Vega and Joe Jackson.
Well, since we're doing that movie, screw both of you, because I picked Bring Out the Dancing Horses by Echo and the Bunny Men.
Yes.
That actually on the soundtrack?
It is. I just looked it up.
I'm out of here.
Dave, you're good. You're good. It was on there. I looked it up. The reason I looked it up, because I was going to throw out Try a Little Tenderness, and that's not
on there. The soundtrack. No, no.
Which breaks my heart.
It's featured in, but not on it.
That's the commitment.
No.
No.
No, this was
that
the
Otis, baby.
It was the Otis.
That is
Otis. Version.
That is John.
That's
Pryor
the one whenever,
dancing
whenever
around
Ducky
the room,
comes in and does his whole little mime thing.
I really hate you.
All right, I'm going to throw one out here. It's my turn, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see.
Actually, no, because you went with.
Well, technically, it goes back around to you then, because he threw out Echo and the Bunnymen. So.
Okay, so it's back to me.
Yeah, it's back to you and your garbage choices.
1987. Oh, no, I can't do that one. Bum, bum, never bum. Mind. because it's the name of the
what
movie.
What was it?
Who's That Girl by Madonna. I've got one, though. Never mind. From At Close Range, Madonna, Live to Tell.
Okay, I'll allow it.
Yeah, no, that's, it was on the, Sean Penn and...
not a good movie.
Christopher Walken.
Not a good movie.
Yeah, really based not. On a... Something that happened here in Tennessee.
Yep.
Yeah.
Still not a good movie.
It's a good song, though.
Well, I will go with another animated movie, which I'm surprised that neither one of you two have thrown out here, knowing what kind of geeks you are.
Did you go with heavy metal?
No. The 1986 classic Transformers the Movie, The Touch by Stan Bush.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Okay.
You know, I might have actually put Dare on there over The Touch.
Dare is good. Dare is a good.
Great song. Also could have gone with Weird Al's Dare to Be Stupid.
Oh, God, I forgot that was on there. But so, The Touch, I mean, that's just one of those things of when you're watching the movie, you hear that, it's just like...
Oh, I know. And it's used twice.
Where did this come from?
It comes in twice, you know.
You're right.
Yeah.
All right, Dave.
I knew you had it in you, kid.
1986.
Okay.
Color of Money.
Okay. It's the way that you use it.
Yes.
Yeah. Eric Clapton. You know, that's one of the few Eric Clapton songs I actually like.
There could have been another one off of that.
Yes, there could have been.
Werewolves of London.
Yes.
That scene where he's twirling that damn stick around.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who hasn't tried to do that?
Do you want to double check? No. Make sure it's on a soundtrack?
I know that one's on there. So that one's
Good choice, Dave. Good choice. All right, Alan.
But you see why we had to, because of the Can't Buy Me Love thing.
I know, and
the Do the Right Thing thing. So
I quit. Like, I quit. I'm not doing this anymore.
1987, The Bengals with Hazy Shade of Winter off the
Less Than Zero
soundtrack.
Yeah. It's a good song.
It is a great song.
It's a great cover.
Yeah. It's a great cover. But that's one of those, like, I think they did a better version of it than Simon and Garfunkel.
Was it actually Simon and Garfunkel, or was it just Paul Simon?
Simon and Garfunkel.
Okay. I could never remember if it was just him solo or not.
Nope.
All right. What is my next one? Oh, I've got it. From another cult classic. Another 1985 cult classic. Barry Gordy's The Last Dragon.
El DeBarge.
Rhythm of the Night by El DeBarge. I almost went with The Glow.
Yeah, the Rhythm of the Night.
But Rhythm of the Night, man, just
a much better song.
Or what was the other one? I think Stevie Wonder had a song on there called "Upset Stomach" or something.
Like that.
It was just
bad. Yeah.
This was in the bad time for Stevie. All right,
Dave, one of these days we are going to do that What the 80s Did episode of all the bad music that good artists put out during that time period.
I don't want to do this anymore.
It's okay. I'm out anyway.
I don't want to do this.
This is it.
I've got a couple more.
Because he's probably going to be like, well, I didn't have a soundtrack.
Go ahead.
1985.
Yes.
Hold on. Let me get ready. Okay.
What you got? 85. What do you got?
Weird Science.
Okay.
Which song?
Does it have a soundtrack?
I don't know.
Dave
yes,
is
it does.
Gritting his teeth
original
right
soundtrack.
Now.
Soundtrack. Here we are. What song?
Killing Joke.
'80s.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's on there.
I'm out.
That's on there.
Are you tapping? Is that your last one?
That's the last one. I quit.
All right.
I don't have anything else.
I've got a couple more on this, and then we can discuss.
Weird Science was actually one of the songs that originally popped in my head of like, oh, that's a great, the name of the song of the movie. So
I'm surprised nobody picked up Valley Girl doing I Melt With You by Modern English.
Nah. I hate that song.
If I
never hear that song again.
I think that song got played
let's
death
put it this
afterwards.
Way. Let's put it this yes. way. When all of a sudden 80s retro became really big
that's
in the early
the
90s. That song, and then Burger King picked it up, and they used it for their, you know, whatever it was. But then, that is one of those songs that if you go anywhere to karaoke, somebody's going to sing that song. And they're going to be flat when they're doing the stuff.
Of course.
Always.
Well, you know, I found out long ago, it's a long way down to Holiday Road. Again.
That's a good one.
Surprised nobody picked up Lindsey Buckingham
from
Vacation,
Holiday Road.
Man.
No, I left it alone on purpose.
Oh, that's a good one.
So. I don't want to play this game anymore.
Well, we're right. out anyway.
I have three more.
All right.
We're done. All right. I thought about doing Princes of the Universe from Highlander because it was the soundtrack for that and it was the theme song for the damn TV show.
Was Who Wants to Live Forever on that soundtrack?
So here's the problem with that. Highlander didn't have a soundtrack.
Okay, so that was the thing.
That's why I didn't choose it.
Yeah.
Because the Highlander soundtrack was the Queen album, A Kind of Magic.
Yes, yes.
It was the whole damn thing. The only soundtrack
I would have allowed
ever did
that,
was Flash Gordon.
I would have allowed that, though.
Okay.
Because it's kind of the same thing that happened with
Who Made Who.
Because
true.
It is the soundtrack for... All the music that's on there is in the movie,
right?
But it's technically an AC/DC album. Rock and Roll High School is the same thing. Rock and Roll High School is technically a Ramones album.
Is it? I thought it actually was released as
it is released as a Ramones album.
Okay.
It does say soundtrack to the movie, whatever, but it's listed under the Ramones.
All right. So the other three that I have, and I'm surprised none of us picked this one up, from the 1980 classic, The Blues Brothers.
No, I
left it alone on purpose.
I looked at it and I was just like,
Respect by Aretha Franklin.
Yeah, I left it alone on purpose.
Why?
Because I figured one of you two
on there.
Yes.
Or you think? Or are you talking about Think?
You better think. I'm sorry. You're
think
right.
Think about what you're trying to do to me. Yeah, as you were saying, I didn't think Respect was on that one. So it was a.
And that again, you talk about an album that you could have literally picked just about any song
because she does say R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Yes, she brings in the breakdown
and then goes into the you know.
But you could have gone with that. You could have gone with "Shake a Tail Feather" by Ray Charles. You could have gone with any.
I Need You. That's a great one.
Somebody to Love
or Somebody to Love. Yeah, it's a.
What do you want for nothing?
Rubber biscuit. But they're
chips. Yeah.
We're going to do a part two of this for 90s stuff.
All right. I'm down.
No, I'm not playing this game
Barry
anymore.
Barry and I are going to do a part two of this for
because this is my last episode. I'm not doing this anymore. I quit.
You're going to miss a really cool episode later then.
So. I have two more. Another one, a 1986, and I love this freaking movie. I will watch this movie anytime that it is on television. I will not flip channels. I will actually flip channels to get to it.
Mm-hmm.
From the movie Running Scared.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Sweet Freedom by Michael McDonald.
I was getting ready to say, you're going to Michael McDonald.
I'm going to Michael motherfucking McDonald this song.
You know one that I'm kind of surprised none of us did also?
What's that?
Maybe not surprised, but if I... All right, I'm going to say this. When I started putting this together, I figured my last four or so are all going to be like power ballads.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is that like my first one that I was going with After All, with the Peter Cetera and Cher, and I was like, oh, great. Not a soundtrack for Chances Are. And I really don't like The Glory of Love that much, so that one didn't make it on there.
Yeah.
And I started thinking, and Phil Collins song that I said, Against All Odds, name of the movie, can't do that.
Yep.
So I didn't get my power ballads the way that I really wanted to, but this one just kind of popped in my head. It's not really a power ballad, but from the movie White Nights.
Say You Say Me
by Lionel Richie.
That fits. I mean,
but
sure, that is a soundtrack.
I'm positive because I almost bought it recently on vinyl. Yeah, so it's
sure that song's on the soundtrack.
It is on there. I looked.
I'm gonna finish up with this, and then we can discuss any honorable mentions that we wanted to. from the 1984 original classic. Now it's kind of lauded for being a bit rapey.
Which one? Revenge of the Nerds.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bone Symphony, One Foot in Front of the Other. That is, I'm sorry, there's a lot of songs that are off that soundtrack.
And saying that movie is kind of rapey, saying that Kevin Smith is kind of high. Well, it's...
he actually stopped. He announced that he is no longer smoking weed.
I believe it when I see it.
That could have been just for Thursday, but who knows?
I know, it's fine. Consider he's been doing it every day since 2008.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, we'll see. He's probably on ayahuasca like Ron White started using ayahuasca to quit drinking.
Yeah, that's just no.
So he just wants to vomit all the time?
Yeah, pretty much.
He traded one form of vomiting a lot for another vomit.
He's evidently, quote, microdosing.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I don't even know what that means.
But about the microdosing? That's been all the rage here like the last couple of years. You take small doses of hallucinogens to help your mental state. And I'm like, to help it like really go batshit insane.
You're not wrong. All right. So we talked a lot about these songs. We talked a lot about the soundtracks in general. And let's be honest, there's a lot that we didn't hit.
There are so many.
Are you sure there's a soundtrack for those?
I'm positive.
Some of them, yeah. Most of them. Most of them.
And they're not titled after the movie either.
That's right. And the songs are actually on the soundtrack rather than in the movie.
If you think about it, there's several movies that have just banger soundtracks that we didn't even touch. We didn't talk about like Dirty Dancing.
There's a reason why.
There's a ton.
I went and looked at that. Dirty Dancing and More Dirty Dancing.
Yes.
Thinking, okay, first off, I hate that fucking I've Had the Time of My Life song.
That's not
But it. I started going down the line of stuff, and most of it was stuff from the the 60s, you know?
There were a few.
And then the other stuff like Hungry Eyes or She's Like the Wind that I'm like, there's no way I'm putting these on
just
here.
Just for the cheese factor, I would not throw those on there, and, you know?
Because let's be honest, Patrick Swayze can't sing.
Well, he had one decent attempt at it. It was in a movie called, what was the one where him and Liam Neeson were brothers from the South and they moved up?
Next of Kin.
Next of Kin. He does a song in there called Brothers, and it's not bad. It's not great.
Surprised no one put Roadhouse on this with the
Jeff Healy.
Jeff Healy band.
There's so many. But again, that's one of those ones. What song do you choose?
I know. Well,
you know, I there's so many different ones off of that, and I think that there's
David's seething over here. I was really expecting somebody. I wasn't going to do it, but I figured would probably I'm pointing at you, Dave.
Yeah, he's pointing at me.
Would actually put the score for something on here.
I thought about
you
that.
Know
I thought about the Tangerine Dream song from
Risky Business.
Risky Business.
Yeah, you know. Well, I thought Raiders of the Lost Ark or Red Dawn.
You didn't say original movie score.
I said songs from a soundtrack.
Yeah,
those were on the soundtrack.
Those are the original movie. There's a difference between the original movie soundtrack and original movie
but
score.
Sometimes on the soundtrack, the score is on the soundtrack. So you can
not always
look at that.
Back to the Future.
Yeah, Back to the Future is like that.
The Alan Silvestri stuff is all throughout.
Transformers a movie. Yes. There are three. Yep. There's three parts of the score.
The way the rules were laid out, that did not.
You just didn't read them correctly. So, it's
which is another one. You know, we didn't hit Back to the Future. I mean, nobody hit Power of Love.
What did I say? What did I say? We said this on a previous episode. That if Dave ever writes an autobiography, it's going to be called "I Didn't Understand the Assignment," or "I Misunderstood the Assignment," or whatever it was. I know. Biscuit, get him. Get him, Biscuit. Anyways, I mean, there are so many, because again, we're covering a decade of movies.
Yeah. And I mean, not just a decade of movies. We're talking about a decade that contained some years that had some of the best
84.
Movies.
I mean, look at all the 84 stuff that we had. You know, 84 and 86 both. Yeah. Just tons and tons of stuff.
And
then soundtracks like Top Gun or Footloose or Beverly Hills Cop, where you could have gone five deep on these
easily.
Of stuff, mean,
you know, and it's hard to find that one song. And I guess when I put my list together, I don't know what kind of guidelines you guys went by, but when I put my list together, I was like, okay, if I hear that song just out in the ether, out in the public, do I instantly go back to a scene from that movie? And every one of the songs that I listed, yes. When I hear that, I'm like, oh, I remember when this was in this movie and it was going on here.
You know, if we really wanted to be assholes about the rules on this.
When has that ever stopped us?
You guys weren't?
I said really want to be assholes about it. Mm-hmm. We could have said, okay, can't be the name of the movie, and it cannot be featured in a training montage.
Oh, you just cut half my list, dude. You just cut half my damn list. Rude.
That would have really been like, oh,
you're just now catching that?
Oh, hurtful. Just so hurtful. But I think that's actually one thing that I found very interesting in doing all this, though, is it does kind of speak to what these...
You know when we forgot?
What?
Over the Top. Come on, we're going to meet him halfway across the sky.
It goes to my Loggins rule. my Loggins column
rule.
Well,
that's the whole thing. We can look at soundtracks from the 80s, okay? Kenny Loggins is on a ton of them, okay? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Soundtracks from the 90s. Bryan Adams
and Phil Collins.
Pretty much.
Phil Collins for the 80s and
he went across both of them.
He was the carryover.
But Bryan Adams became that soundtrack guy in the 90s. Where it's like, wow,
Big time.
Yeah. And God, some of the worst music. And I like Bryan Adams.
And the sad part is, how do you take Bryan Adams, Rod Stewart, and Sting?
It's real easy to screw that up.
And come on.
I think you put Bryan Adams, Rod Stewart, and Sting in the same room, and it's already screwed up. So it's...
that's one that I will never
forget. Kind of like putting the three of us together in the same room.
He's not wrong. He is not wrong.
But at least we're entertaining.
Rude. At least two of us are.
Rude.
I know.
Well, I will
Sometimes Dave needs to talk more.
I'm looking forward to the 80s one, the 90s one. This ought to be kind of interesting when we start doing this, because... I don't know. I'm curious
Good thing
to see
this isn't a video podcast.
I may stab him before this episode is over.
Just stab him in his big toe.
So this is what 50 looks like. Huh?
Wow. Would you get us out of here,
50%
please?
50%
angrier. He has officially ran out of dams to give. You know that.
Join us next episode where I list off my least favorite podcasters.
That was probably going to be a boring episode.
Wow.
All right, it's guys.
The whole list, Joe Rogan. But go ahead.
I was going to say Alan Smith.
All right, well, fair.
Yeah, so go to Discord. Sorry, I had to regroup there.
Yes.
Go to Discord. Definitely. Tell us what you're... By our rules,
yes.
No, it can't be the name of the song. Can't be the name of the movie. Has to be on the soundtrack.
Yep.
And what was my other rule? Oh, it has to be on a soundtrack that was actually featured in the 80s.
Yes.
Rather than something later, or an 80s song later, or whatever.
No carryovers.
Yeah. So yeah, tell us what your favorite songs are. Always, you can get in touch with us there, or you can email us projectgenxpod@gmail.com. Of course, all of the links to our social media that we sometimes check are in the show notes, and we're gonna be back with another episode
soon
that I can't off the top of my head remember, but you'll know next week.
Yep.
So for everybody here on the Project Gen X, I am Alan Smith.
I am no longer Big Dave.
You're not? I'm looking right at you. You're still Dave.
You still
look
like Big Dave.
I'm a very confused fairy.
And we will see you next time.
I quit! After all the stops and starts, we keep coming back to these two hearts. Two angels who've been rescued from the fall. When love is true.